So, welcome back to a First Impressions feature. We are diving into a habit tracking app called Awesome Habits, and we're going to be breaking down whether it's a good one for you. This one is available through Mac and iOS. Don't worry, folks, I've heard all your feedback about doing Android apps, and I have got an Android phone, which I will be reviewing very soon from. We're going to dive into this one and check out whether it's worth it to download as a habit tracker on your device. Before we begin, today's sponsor is AkiFlow. If you want to consolidate all your tasks by bringing them from all of your to-do list applications and project management software and be able to time block in one, then AkiFlow is a really good tool for you. You can find it linked below and check out any other resources we've got for AkiFlow there as well. So here we are with Awesome Habits, and it is available on Setup, which is linked below as well, but you can download the iOS app too. Here we go. So we've got it downloaded already. It says here it's got 150,000 plus downloads with a 7.8 rating. So let's see what it can do. So here we go. First off, really like the sort of clean interface that it has here. And this is obviously working on Mac. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add my first habit. So automatically, I see they've already got some good negative habits here already. In this case, I might want to start doing meditation because I actually have been thinking about doing something like this. And you can set here whether you want to build a habit or break a habit, which is a really good one because some of these habit trackers tend to focus only on the positive habits, and it can be really good to avoid doing that. And I want to make this a weekly goal. And you can also set a custom repeat, but in this case, I just want to do it every week. And that's how I want to measure it. You can also measure it by unit as well, by like the count you have. So my weekly goal might be 3, which is much more suitable for me. And I can set a reminder here as well, which comes up in the app reminders. So I'm going to add the habit. And as you can see here, it's popped up open. And let's say, hypothetically, I did do it today. So you can see here that it ticks off. And I can also add a note here as well. So I can say, this was a good session, and press done. Now you can view the notes here, or you can see any historical data on the habit itself, which is really helpful, in which you can archive as well. And you can also change the value too. You can edit the habit, making sure that you're keeping track of them. Now there's a history function here, which is quite cool. So you can see your overview of your longest streak ever and what icon it was, which is quite cool. And you can see your sort of progress for the week. And obviously this is going to be based on 100% whether you completed all of them. So here you can also see individual habits and tracking. It's quite nice. I can do a couple of things to the appearance. I can make it a dark mode. I can make it a light mode or automatic. And I can have vacation mode as well. There is also on the iPhone app an ability to do Apple Sync, which helps to sync with your Apple Health data, which means that I believe it might take a few habits from the data that you sync with your Apple Watch automatically so that you don't miss from manually adding them, which is a large improvement for sure. So you can see the large ring can count all your goals up, and you can remove the large ring if you want. You can show streaks, you can remove sounds, and you can choose to start there the week, which is all very nice. And there are additional widgets you can access on mobile version as well. So if I were to say I've managed to actually do 5, what did I do here? If every time you press it, it comes up with an indication of your history in doing it. So you can see that I've done 6 this week, which is sort of a bit of a jump, but you can see that that's very sensitive to that. If you want to add another habit, you can go up to the top right hand corner. You can do stuff like negative habits, like no screen time, which is a negative habit, but also comes up as a positive habit in a way. And that's how you can tick them off there. You can scribble through your days as well, which is something I've just noticed. But all in all, it's quite a simple habit tracking application. And you can get it through the Set App subscription. But as you can imagine, it's quite basic in nature. I thought it was going to be more complicated, but it does what it says on the tin. And that's all you really want with a habit tracking app. Especially because they're less common on Mac devices for sure. So Awesome Habits, available in the link in the description. Thank you very much for watching. We'll be back with a first impressions very soon, and I hope to see you all there. So cheerio.